So, ganyan. Yan ang lineup ng Omega. For the Warriors, Wolf, ang huli nila pinili, Masha.
Yeah.
Are they drafting not to lose here by immediately applying pressure on the split lane, split push lane? Or is there a deeper reason kung bakit sila nag-Masha?
So, this is a hero na siguro problematic for Chang kasi, well, technically speaking, kayang pigilan ni Chang ang wave clear or push or kaya niyang ubusin ng buhay ni Masha. But Masha is a hero na sobrang bilis niya kasi mag-take ng objectives. He won't care about the damage over time na nakukuha mo from the meteor shower. Plus, it's a good laner. If you're looking at the heroes of the side of Smart Omega, pwede mong i-argue na malakas si Masha over Chang sa side lanes or sa Uranus. That being said, it seems like Kurt Teezy will now play as a support for Smart Omega.
Ooh, okay. So si Kurt Teezy ang nag-flex. Kenji still going to his side lane kung saan natin siya ina-expect. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to game number one. It's the Signal Ultra Warriors versus Smart Omega. This tournament is under the supervision and regulation of the Games and Amusements Board. Here we go. Simulan na natin to. Wolf, it's Der versus Kenji in the top lane. Down bottom, si Toshi laban kay Rhea. And yun na nga, it's the Masha versus the Chang'e matchup and SMO decides to go for the purple first.
If you play it right, kaya mo mag-lane against this Chang'e. And, pero syempre, this is Toshi. He knows how to play the mage in the side lanes. He's just that kind of guy. At pwede natin expect yan. I wanna say naman, itong ating Uranus versus Tams. Tams is actually comfortable here. Na tinatanong ko yung mga Tams players and they're actually very comfortable playing against Uranus kasi mas mabilis sila mapag-respond sa teamfights dahil mas mabilis yung kanilang wave clear technically speaking compared to a Uranus.
Mm-hmm. Ionic Edges, medyo kulang ka pa. Level 2 you get Ionic Edge. Yeah. But with the access first coming in, the Sickles coming in first. Ooh. From the Tams. Yeah, there is doing good. Hold up, Imba DJ, kanina pa, muntik nang mamatay. Heatau in trouble, there's the Tempest, the Blades. Hindi pa rin makuha ni Janus. Vincente coming in from the sides. Kinulang din. Nagaambahan sila. Omega and the Warriors in mid. Heath spotted out here by Vincente. Nagsistretching si Heath. May mahanap pa siya and they disengage. Wolf Cortese here. Is this the first time we're seeing him in mid and the first time he's playing Selena?
Yeah. This is first time natin makita na parang mage support niya itong si Cortese. Needs to help top lane. Kenji had to burn the Purify. Ang interesting yung choice na pinili niya eh. Going for Dreadnought armor na casually. Kasi alam niya na si Thams. Kaso halata na yatang may gumagalaw dito. Kasi, I mean, Kenji has been bullied into the top lane. Tapos bigla na lang siyang confident. This is their knowing na may nangyayari na talaga dito.
It's a mentality thing. But there is fine. There pops the Otra and Inferno. Pero na Phantom Execution siya dito. It may have been or not. But again, a big three-man rotation like that. What can you expect? In mid, Heath just keeping his cool. Dito Wolf, the tables have turned, no? Nabaliktad. First blood goes to Smart Omega. The Warriors seem to have a hard time being on the aggressive side.
Yeah. Well, that is the problem with Ling. Kasi na sobrang item def. I mean, compared mo lang naman dun sa, kung i-compare mo lang dun sa kanyang matchup, which is Lancelot versus Ling, Lancelot syempre ang mauuna yan sa pagkikot. And Ling will have to reserve himself na pagtitignan ng jungle. Now, it's gonna be up to Ben Sanity, the tank, the Paksha, as well as Imba DJ, kung paano nila i-equalize itong kanilang mga, itong aggression na ginagawa ng Smart Omega.
Yep. Oh, Heath catches him off guard. There's the jump into the bush. Nag-aaraw ng target. And sisimula na nga dito ni Hajizi ang turtle. Bensanity ni Badije, medyo mababa ang buhay. There's Kenji coming in with the Ionic Edge. Nag-aaraw ng target. Poisson's already popped here by Bensanity. Fireballs thrown out by Imbadije. Mababa ang buhay. First goes down. Bensanity, nabawian. Heath, we're trading tanks, ladies and gentlemen. Nakapag-ult na yata dito si Hajizi. Wala na siya. Janus already. Still on cooldown ang kanyang Tempest of Blades. And here we see the recent patch, Wolf. Dinagdagan ng cooldown ang Tempest of Blades. And dito natin nakikita agad na kinulang.
Yes.
Feeling ko isa pang kill yun eh. One more at least for the Warriors if only Tempest of Blades were off cooldown.
Yeah. That is one thing na kailangan i-watch out ng mga teams when they go up against Smart Omega and Granny Pro. Ang ganito na mag-abuse ng mga ganun timings. They know when to fight. Look at Cortese. Now, okay.
Oh, another one for Hajizi. Pero nabawian. Selena goes down. Tempest of Blades once more. Knocking up Hajizi. Imba DJ throw it out the spells. But it's just not enough heat here. Helping Peel. Rhea. Kaabalik niya lang sa lane niya. it's not looking good so far for the Warriors. But up top, Nabawian there takes down Kenji 1v1. Wolf, nakita na natin dito. Early game, mas mabilis, mas maganda ang dueling capabilities ng isang Tams.
Oh, Tams is top tier sa ngayon. Lalo na after all of the nerves that are heinous. Sabi mo sa itanong mo sa akin yung question na yon about months ago. I would have said na Uranus favored, but now it's not after all the nerves.
Toshi, medyo napaasim, stayed for too long. He could not knock up Rhea or Ben Sanity. Nakalibre sila, daming gold doon ha. Nung pagbugbog nila doon sa Outer Shield turret, that was pretty good. That's a lot of gold going over to the Warriors, almost equalizing the gold here. 13.3k, both sides now, 5 minutes in.
Yep. I think this is also off of the pick-ups or 1v1 matches na naipapanalo ng Signal Ultra Warriors, particularly on the side lanes. Tams winning against Serenus, that's definitely big para sa Signal Ultra Warriors. At least killing him. Kasi naman, lumalaman ngayon si Kenji sa gold dahil sa kanilang other third energy shield na nakuha.
Yeah, but in the jungle dito sa may purple buff, bumagsak na si Bensanity. Another Phantom execution, well-placed ult by Hajizi, taking out the tank of Signal Ultra Warriors, and they disengage very casually. Wolf, ganun lang, papasok kami, kuha kami isa, we're out. They don't need to convert too much. It's because side naman ng Warriors yun eh. So basically yung Omega, sila yung bisita, kumuha lang sila ng ulam dun sa fridge ng Warriors as umalis. Nakalibre silang isa.
What I like about what Hajizi is doing is naging alam niya kasi yung mga kinakainisan ng isang Ling, which is to lose the purple buff in these timings.
Again, just as you mentioned, Wolf, side lanes, nananalo ang Signal Ultra Warriors. But when it comes to big ticket engagements, it's all about Omega. And what is Kenji doing inside the base? Napalalim yata yung cut niya.
Might down. Say na malalim to, Leo, but actually this is a set play para sa Smart Omega. Look what he did. He tried to attract the attention of Signal Ultra Warriors at mag-cut ng dalawang waves para naman yung lanes ay pressured against Signal Ultra Warriors while Smart Omega are taking the turtle. That's a set play.
Yep, it's the distraction play. And again, clutch time Kenji doing clutch time Kenji things. First turret goes down bottom for the Warriors. Omega loses that first tier turret. And there, Wolf, there, this is his debut game in the Nationals. Medyo maganda ang hulog ni Der ngayon on that Tams. Tier 1 hero with a tier 1 player on it. But yeah, medyo hindi siya binibigyan ng magandang mid game dito ng Omega, kasi again it's a three man gank and they lose a turret, but at least nagets na ni Der hit with the ult and Mamba out. Bensanity rolling out, Imba DJ backing out looking for the targets. Hajizi goes for the Phantom execution to disengage. Sa baba naman Rhea versus Kenji. Ito ang interesting matchup din. Rhea is losing this, he's backing out Flicker.
Yun yung sa hero na walang pakialam sa disarm ni Masha. It also deals so much damage at damage over time. I wanna say though, Tams, yung fact na 7 minutes bago pa siya napushan in without any help from Signal Ultra Warriors at all, and it tells me na merong alam itong si Der na probably ngayon lang din natin makikita in how to play the Tams in a lane na in a dead lane, basically speaking.
Oh, wait lang, napasabugan si Imba DJ ng full combo ni Hajizi. And again, the KDA machine, ladies and gentlemen, showing up. Janus waiting here in the bush. Heath walks in. And again, yan ang trabaho na isang tank, no? Bang face check. And there's the Poissons by Bensanity. Heath bouncing ball out. That's one ult down. Wolf, I think, Smart Omega, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, they are 100% on the turtle this time.
Oh, definitely. What you said about face checking, nag-coincide siya dun sa idea na gusto gawin ng Smart Omega, because they definitely want to take that turtle. And ito yung Smart Omega power. Alam nila kung paano maggawa ng mga play so that they can take these big objectives. So the moment that they saw na nabawasan nila yung mga heroes like the Baksha and the other heroes of Signal Ultra Warriors, they don't even need the kill para mag-start ng turtle. Yung fact na 50% HP na lang yung kalaban nila, it just means na go signal na yun for the turtle take.
Yep, and because of this side lane tendency ng Signal Ultra Warriors, alam na ni Toshi na medyo, guys, ito na ako eh. Thank you na lang kay mamaya sa akin. I'm gonna bait out the Ling. I'm gonna call on Janus. And for the first time, Janus makes a failed rotation. That's a big loss for Janus, given that he wasted, 10-15 seconds trying to take down Toshi. And Wolf, correct me if I'm wrong, Toshi here, kapag hinayaan to ng Signal to Warriors, baka secondary corner rin to. And baka maging kryptonite to ng isang Ling later on in the game.
Oh, dalawa na yung items niya at 9 minutes. He's at 5.8k. Almost near the Ling. So to answer your question, well, sobrang threat na niya even right now. Using his positioning, kung mapapansin mo kay Toshi, kahit pa na-push yung kanyang lane, ngayon, eh, problema na siya.
Ooh, here's a big engagement. Meteor Shower already put in by Toshi. There, medyo mababa ng buhay, Insanity. Does he have the poisons? He does not, cannot pop it right here. Medyo na-delay siya. There's the Tyrant's Rage, knocking out. Back siya. Janus, mababagsak na rin. That's a 2-for-none in favor of Smart Omega. Sana lang jungle pa. The Warriors fall down, losing out the mid turret. Amazing conversion rates here for Smart Omega. They're gonna take another 2-for-2. Heroes and turrets. Omega is burying the Warriors in value. Wolf, what can the Warriors do here? They're 10 minutes in and the map is already blue.
Well, what they can do is utilize itong si Rhea at yung kanyang pwedeng split pushing potential. And now, look to consider how they can utilize Imba DJ, pati na rin yung kanilang mga combo to clear the minion waves. That is their priority ngayon. Kailangan nakashove at least yung lanes against Smart Omega. If that's not possible, at least sa gitna lagi nakikita yung mga minions. Because as long as Smart Omega controls the map right now, hindi sila makapag-farm. I have to take note, Signal Ultra Warriors, they have decent late game potential. But without those lanes pushing against Smart Omega, hindi nila ma-utilize yun.
Yeah, and so far, ito na yung sinasabi ko eh. I'm not sure what Masha is right now, kung nasaan siya sa tier list ng metagame ngayon. But as soon as the Warriors picked her, I felt like they were drafting or picking a hero not to lose, essentially. Yeah. Kasi ang dami pang ibang mas malalakas sa side laners eh, na mas proactive, right, na mas maganda yung hulog in team fights or like from early to mid, able to apply pressure more consistently. But right now, wala na, nandiyan na tayo eh. Like, we were already 11 minutes in, 30 seconds. First Lord marching down mid, and the side lane advantage that the Warriors have set early on, not even here anymore. Tempest of Blades right now, dueling. Hajizi versus Janus. Janus losing, he needs to back out of here. Hajizi pushing him back. I'm wondering, may purple ba si Janus ngayon? Dahil hirap na hirap siya.
It seems like hindi. Kasi nandun pa, buhay pa yung purple buff. Kasi look at the zone out potential of this Chang'o. It's crazy. It's crazy for Smart Omega. Lalo na na napatas ng item nila. So everybody's a core right now for Smart Omega.
In perspective though, versus the Warriors, and now knocked up there. Medyo delikado, popping the Cotret Inferno, kaya lang siya nabuhay doon. Life stealing along the way. Mid, butas na. Lamang dito ng Smart Omega, 7,000 gold. Well, 7,000 gold, that's what? 2 or 3 core items across the board.
Yeah. That is definitely true. Pwede mo i-distribute na rin sa mga supports. Like this, Courtesy is at 3 items para na rin siyang core. Kasi technically, dalawa pa nga lang yung item delay. That's how big, massive this is. Lalo lang na naka-mystery shop siya, Calamity Reaper, and Clock of Destiny, plus the Durance now coming out from the Selena. He's definitely a threat as well.
Yep, and again, this is a nice debut for Courtesy as a support player. So definitely guys, nakita nyo yung mechanical prowess ng isang side laner pumapasok. I think what matters na lang is the adjustment on the mentality, no? Tsaka yung mga tendencies mo. So already, Smart Omega flexing a bit here in their very first game in the second season of the Nationals. What's the next move for the Warriors though? Obviously, damage control sa mid, clear it out. Who would you place there, Wolf? Would Imba DJ be enough? And if that means if Imba DJ is stuck in mid defing, ibig sabihin hindi sila makapag-aggressive plays with the Valir.
It's more of no choice na talaga yun, Leo. As much as I want to say na pwede sana ng lumabas labas at makipag team fight itong si Imba DJ, he definitely needs to take care of the lanes. And that's also true with Dare. He also opted for a semi tanky build para kay Dare dito na prepping siguro for the storm that's happening. It might not be enough as we're seeing it. And like that is Smart Omega, pwede nila systematically tagal to, or maybe a little bit flashy with Hajizi in there.
Yep, no cost at all. Isang Phantom execution lang, 404, error not found. There were very few times in this matchup, 14 minutes in, na nagkamali ang Smart Omega. Maybe that one time na nag-asim si Kenji, nakipag 1-on-1 siya kay Der. But right now, so far, they're not making the wrong mistakes. Alam mo yun, may mga mali na okay lang, na in the end, will correct itself. And this is definitely Smart Omega's game to lose. Nasa kanila ang bola. And now, Wolf, this is just Janus helping out. This is Janus doing his little bits. Kinakat niya na yung lanes. Alam niya kaya niyang gumalaw agad-agad. And that's some breathing room for the mid lane.
Some breathing room, but I think kailangan pa rin na mas marami pa. Now, big push coming up from Omega. Ben Santi jumping, pero Leo, oh! This is bad.
Kenji in the backlight, Ionic Edge sa mga minions. Unstoppable, Hajizi is a pang Phantom Execution, taking out Ben Sanity. And even if that is just the tank, malaking bagay pa rin yan. That's still someone to help heal and to stop the frontline damage from the Omega squad. And the Warriors find themselves here in a conundrum. In a pickle, if you will. Ooh. Stop between a rock and a hard place. Quick pause here. Correct me if I'm wrong, Wolf. Butas na rin yung bottom. And they're now just defending top. The last turret.
The last inhibitor na available ngayon para sa Signal Ultra Warriors. I think na biglang lumabas yung problema ngayon ng Signal Ultra Warriors when I saw Ben Sanity jump. Maybe this is the reason kung bakit na sa masamang posisyon ngayon ang Signal Ultra Warriors. They're not that coordinated, Leo. Not as much as Smart Omega, though. Si Smart Omega, you see them, they make a play, they're together. At least kung tatlo man yung kasama dun sa play na yun, maganda yung synchronization nila. When they were setting up for turtles, when they're setting up for objectives, meron talagang nakaplano. But when it comes to Signal Ultra Warriors, it seems like everybody's just trying to make the play for their own. Tama naman yun. I mean, it makes sense. Pero in a professional game of this stage, tapos kalaban nila is a finalist caliber kind of team, hindi ka pwedeng gumagawa ng sarili mo ng play. You have to communicate with your team. You have to coordinate it. Kasi a Baksha cannot do it all alone. I mean, siguro pag nag-god mode Baksha ka, kaya mo. But at the same time, man, you need to coordinate with your team. That defense from Signal Ultra Warriors, sobrang telling niya kung ano yung naging problema ng Warriors sa game na to.
Yep, and I think this was evident already in the draft. No, we did note that in the draft, it seemed like they were not at all reacting to what Omega was doing. Yep. They were just drafting what comfort picks they had or what lineup Coach Yevmeister may have planned out for this. And right now, again, yung onting interaction or yung onting counterplay na pwede natin makita, It's evident now. And there you go. A nice attempt by Janus to steal the Lord. Not gonna be enough. Hajizi taking him down. Monster kill. Ni Isandet wala pa dito sa KDA machine natin. 6-0-4 on this Lancelot. Janus now taken out. Where else can they find the pickoff? This is all out defense for the Warriors. They have to pick it out from somewhere.
I wonder where that will be. 100% kill participation para kay Hajizi. So if we're looking for a play that's plausible para Signal Ultra Warriors, maybe get a pickoff outside, maybe jump on the Chango while it is happening, tapos hintay nila na magbato na ng skill si Hajizi. I don't think that's gonna happen anytime soon, but I don't know, maybe Signal Ultra Warriors, miracles can happen.
Ooh, Insanity erased just like that by Toshi. Lord helping Whale onto the base. Ladies and gentlemen, a double kill na rin dito onto there si Toshi. And just like that, huwag kang kukurap. Game number one closes up. Smart Omega taking it quick 1-0 in this best of three. Wolf, the fundamentalists here, Smart Omega, they played on formula. They played 1 plus 1 equals 2. I do this, tapos sundan nyo nito, ito yung resulta. It was very easy to read as a viewer. Medyo nagets agad natin. And I think the responsibility here falls onto Signal Ultra Warriors. They're the ones who has to make the huge adjustments. Now, before we look into the post-game stats, I think we can already give a few pointers here. We can already point out, no, yung mga pwede lang ayusin.